Hey guys, sorry about the very horrible quality. I usually film this on my MacBook Pro, but that's currently down right now. That's what we're here to talk about today. So I'm filming this on my iMac. Anyway, started noticing the spinning beach ball, very, very slow opening applications. I have a mid-2010 MacBook Pro, and I put in the Vortex 4 SSD 128. It's been working great for about a year. All of a sudden she started running horribly slow and it would actually lock up where I'd have to restart. Restarted, got it back up to Mac OS, went into console and noticed disk, I think it's 02S or 0S2, detected problems, failing, something like that. So I assumed, oh, that's nice. The SSD is failing. After a lot of playing around, two different drives, spindle drives. I don't have another SSD laying around. I was not able to get it running. However, doing the reinstall. I booted to the internet recovery mode, which is Command R. Will put you into internet recovery mode. Well, you have to partition a new disk and format the disk. Went to go partition the disk, and then you get errors basically saying can't allocate memory, unable to unmount disk, even though it's there, and you can see it, but you cannot format it or partition it. Also, depending on which part of the drive you click on, the actual model number, the manufacturer's name, like the Shiba or OCZ, or you actually click on the actual partition drive, you will get a different error. This error right here, the POSIX error, that is a new one that was coming up quite a bit, so I started to research it, and a lot of people said, this is your problem right here. This actually is the cable that plugs to the logic board. Sits in there just like this, actually. This goes to the hard drive. This is the IR sensor piece. I don't know how something like this can go bad when it's never touched, other than when putting a drive in and out. You're gentle with it, and it's always covered up via the cover. I've never dropped my computer or anything, so I don't know how this could go bad, but I bought it on Amazon. It's like 40 bucks. It's got 5 reviews. And everybody on there, the reviews, having the exact same problems that I'm having. So I overnighted it. I happen to have part number 821-0814-A. Now, I guess that's the manufacturer's part number. Apple's part number, which you'll get off Amazon, I hope, everything is how it should be, is 922-9062. That's what they're sending me. I hope it's the complete, you know, set up with this. I don't really want to have to detach this, as it's like adhesive down there, pretty strong. These are very fragile, I've also read. They're nothing like the iMac internal real SATA cables. But maybe I'll post back with another video. I'll have it tomorrow, and if that works, that saved my day, because it's an excellent computer. Just it's got a bad cable. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a good day.